But among Palestinians and much of the Arab world, Sharon's legacy is a tarnished one. Earlier, I spoke with Rashid Khalidi, professor of Arab studies at Columbia University in New York.
Sharon will be remembered as the architect of the war on Lebanon, in which 17,000 people, mostly civilians, were slaughtered. He'll be remembered as the person who was responsible for the Sabra and Shatila massacres, in which 1,400 innocent people were slaughtered. He will be remembered as the architect of Israel's settlements policy, expanding it massively from the time he was Minister of Agriculture in 1977. So he's a man who is thought of as one of the worst enemies of the Palestinian people. And in among Palestinians and in the Arab world, his death will certainly not be mourned. One has to go back to what Sharon did in his last prime ministership, starting in the year 2000. He launched a reinvasion of those areas of the West Bank that had been ceded to Palestinian control. He dismantled the entire structure of the Palestinian Authority. And he then dictated terms to the Palestinians. If that's negotiation, it's negotiations Israeli style. He also was responsible for the unilateral withdrawal from Gaza, but that was in furtherance of his aim of maintaining and consolidating Israel's control over the West Bank. It should be added that Israel controlled then and still controls the Gaza Strip from the outside. So Israel remained in occupation, but simply ceased to any longer have settlers inside the Gaza Strip or troops permanently stationed there. So I think anyone who prettifies the man's image is essentially falsifying history. This was the architect, as I've said, of one of the most disastrous wars in Israel's history, and the architect of a settlement policy, which has, I think, probably made a two-state solution completely unrealistic. He was not a peacemaker. He was a war maker. And to the end of his days, he had, I think, the same objectives. Mm-hmm.